Under the Penal Code Article 171, as related to Article 172, falsification is, by among other methods, committed by, quote, making any alteration or intercalation. Intercalation means insertion in a genuine document which changes its meaning. And by the way, there is a difference between the term forgery and the term falsification. Under the Penal Code, the term forgery is usually applied to banknotes. For example, if you print Philippine pesos or US dollars, then you're guilty of forgery if you are passing off this counterfeit note as genuine. But if you are falsifying a commercial paper, like a specimen credit card of a bank, that is the crime of falsification. And it is a crime to knowingly introduce in evidence in any judicial proceeding such a falsification. I have a whole list of cases that I looked up when I left the session hall yesterday, but I will just quote a 2010 case because, as you know, in law, the later the decision, the more authoritative it becomes. Ramos v. People, 2010. The elements of falsification of commercial documents are, number one, that there be an alteration or a change or intercalation or insertion on document, that is, it was made on a genuine document, that the alteration or intercalation has changed the meaning of the document, and that the change made the document speak something false. That's the Supreme Court speaking on what is a falsified document. Now, maybe some of us might think that we should call for a handwriting expert, but that is not the jurisprudence. We don't need a handwriting expert, because jurisprudence tells us that mostly courts disregard what a handwriting expert says, and it's up to the judge to determine for himself visually whether what he is seeing before him are, as described by the Penal Code, changes or insertions that tend to give a different meaning to the document. So, the importance of this topic in our impeachment proceedings might overshadow the need to hurry and finish the impeachment trial, because if we can prove, if there is proof on record that the signature specimen cards were falsified as falsification is defined under the Penal Code, then perhaps the court might lean towards considering the maxim, falsus in unum, falsus in omnibus. It is not relevant to say, anyway, the people responsible will have to be accused in a criminal case, and so you have to find somebody who will file an accusation against them. That is completely irrelevant. The question before the impeachment court is, does this Latin maxim, false in one particular, false in all particulars, apply to the instant specimen cards? Thank you.